Hi, this is Dwayne N6DMR. Today I'm going to be going over a quick setup video for the Anytone D878UV radio for APRS settings. Okay, so when we first get the CPS, you'll see that there's nothing in the public menu for APRS. So the first thing we have to do is go into Tools menu and select Options. This is what they call the Annex Function Setting options. You would want to set GPS if your radio is GPS capable, and then also APRS. Now these are options for Bluetooth and 5-hour, 100-hour record. These options are not quite available yet, but if you end up with a Bluetooth module in the radio, you would want to activate the Bluetooth as well. Same for the recording. Okay. So we'll click the OK button and oh, there it is. Now we have an APRS setting for the radio. So before we go there's a couple of quick settings I want to make in the optional settings. This is just a precursor to setting up APRS. So we open up the options here and we're going to go to Other. Okay, and I just want to look down here. Is there anything that I need to do there? No, not really. This is a good. Now we'll go to Digital Functions. Oh, and down at the bottom here, this is a required setup. This is your SMS format or your texting format, and APRS Digital, DMR APRS, uses a SMS type format to send packets. So there's two choices, H or M, and in the case of Anytone, we would choose M. That would be the correct setting, M-SMS. Then just for real quick, GPS and ranging. I have GPS positioning or GPS on, and I actually have GPS positioning on. It really doesn't matter. You don't need that, but it works, so I have that on as well. So at that point, those are the key settings in the optional menu for APRS. So we're going to go ahead and click OK on that. Now we're going to actually look at the APRS setup menu. This has got a lot of stuff going on here, so we're going to kind of break it down for you. The first thing is some standard settings for APRS, which are in this area right here, and they would apply to all APRS sending. This section here is your coordinate entry screen for a fixed beacon, if you so choose to use it. And down at the bottom, this is your analog settings, okay, for analog APRS. And then this section over here is settings for your digital or DMR-APRS. So that's the section how we section this out. So let's first cover analog APRS. So the first thing we do is we need to set these few standard settings that are APRS function only, but for both analog and digital. So the first thing we'll look at is manual transmission interval. I've got this set at 60 seconds. What this does is when you have APRS turned on in your channel, radio channel, and I'm going to show you that as we move on, but when you have that, when APRS is on in the channel, the radio will allow you to send a one-time APRS packet using the PTT manually. So if you're in a QSO, you hit that to start the QSO, and you're going to get an APRS packet to go out. Now, this setting here allows you to continue to press the PTT and have a QSO without the APRS packet going out until this interval is done. So if you first press push to talk, you can continue to press it, but another APRS packet is not going to go out until it's reached the 60-second limit. At that point, after the 60 seconds, if you hit the PTT again, another manual packet will go out, and so on. So I have mine set at 60 seconds. That's a lot. Actually, if I was really not just testing APRS, I'd want to put this up as high as I could, maybe in the 220 range or something like that, okay? because you don't really want to send APS packets every minute. However, for testing purposes, sometimes you want it to go out very quickly, maybe even 30 seconds, so that you can actually see if you're getting packets. Again, this would be a test function. I would not use this normally in your day-to-day operation. So that covers the manual transmit interval. Now, the APRS also has an auto transmit, and there's an interval for that too. Again, if I was testing, I would probably put this on a lower setting. This right now is 10 minutes. The lowest in this particular setting is 1 minute or off, 60 seconds or off. If I was testing APRS for the first time and I wanted to get a lot of packets to make sure it's working, I probably would use 60 seconds. But for long term, I just basically think 10 minutes is a very good interval. You don't want to be blasting APRS all the time through the repeaters, or etc. So, okay, now support for roaming, you can turn that on or off. Roaming is a separate function or feature. I'm not going to be covering in this video, but I will do a video later on it. So for the purposes of today, I'm going to just leave that off. Okay, now we're going to talk about the fixed location beacon. Now there's two settings for this, off and on. When this fixed location beacon is off, the radio will use the GPS, current GPS settings, to send the APRS location report. The APRS only goes out if the GPS is turned on and the GPS has a satellite signal lock, which turns the GPS signal icon in the display from gray to red. So you're looking for that red locked satellite GPS setting. Okay, now if you turn this on, fixed beacon now is on, that opens up and allows editing in this fixed beacon location data fields, which is you could put in your location data and run a fixed beacon. You see it's now open. If I turn this off, it locks it. I mean, it's just a nice little feature. You can't accidentally change anything here. So basically with fixed beacon on, now the radio will use the coordinates in the fixed beacon data entry box right here, and that's what's going to send out. And in this particular case, you do not need an APRS GPS lock. So if you're testing or you're inside and you're not going to be able to get that GPS signal lock, you can turn fixed beacon on and you'd get an accurate location report based on the information that you enter. Okay, so in this particular case, we'll leave it off and we'll let the GPS work on APRS. So moving down, let's discuss analog APRS. So what analog APRS does, it sends in the background an analog FM APRS signal packet to APRS FI, or actually through a repeater, through a digi repeater, or through an iGate to APRS FI. So you need an over-the-air connection that is tied to the internet, like an iGate would be. And if you're unfamiliar with these terms, I would suggest you go ahead and look a little bit at the APRS system, what an iGate does, what a digi repeater does, and etc. Now, many repeaters, but not all repeaters, include an iGate in their setup so that if you're transmitting through their repeater, the iGate will pick up the transmission packet and pass it on to APRS FI or one of the other sites. Okay, so that's a brief description of the analog. Now, we're going to go through these settings. The transmit tone, this will allow you, if you turn it on, to send this annoying sound out of your radio. And it's actually the audio of the packet sending. Interestingly enough, that audio can be decoded using a software programs that will allow you to input audio into them. But in this particular case, it's an indicator that it's sending. If you're sending, when I test that I'm sending every minute, it's annoying after a while. So I turn this off. Normally in my testing, I have a separate radio set to the transmission frequency and I can monitor the radio sending out that way as well. Okay, let's move on. Destination call sign, destination SSID. Okay, destination call sign is not a mandatory requirement. However, sometimes you need this in the packet to get it to be parsed at the location reporting receiving station. You can, if you have a specific iGate or pathway that you wanted to go to, you could put the destination call in there, and you could put the destination SSID or dash number. So in this particular case, the default came this way, and I just leave it this way. Okay, now your call sign and your SSID. This is mandatory if you want to be seen on APRSFI. You put your call sign in here, mine is N6DMR, and then you correctly choose an SSID. There is actually information in the APRS documentations across the internet which describe what these dash numbers do. I typically use dash 5 and dash 6 for my couple radios that I'm using APRS on. So anyway, you would have to assign this. Now, it's important because when you go into APRSFI to check for packets, the packets are specific to this dash number or SSID number. Okay, moving forward. This is the APRS symbol table selection. It's done with a character. In this case, the backslash is the standard table. And then also the map icon that's listed in that table, the ampersand is a standard map icon. Now, the APRS signal path is typically done using the WIDE format. So in my particular case, I like using Y2-2. You again, if you're unfamiliar with using these signal paths, there's plenty of information on the internet. I would recommend you go out and search for WIDE APRS, and you'll get a whole bunch of stuff back. And essentially, this is the format that you use, Y2-2. Now, the next line is sending text. This is the text that will send at the end of your packet that will actually help you when you look at the APRS packet that was sent. Where did this packet come from? You can put it in here. So I'm telling the text here that I'm sending from Y2-2. I'm sending APRS from the AnyTone. This is my dash number it's coming from, and it's call sign, and I'm actually beacon and analog. So even though I have this off, normally I would have it on for this particular setting, but it's not important. You can change this text any way you want it. Now, the next section for APRS analog is to select the transmission frequency. The frequency in the United States is 144.39. That's the standard analog FM APRS channel. And that's what you should put in here to send. The delay times, they're intricate. You can use what you want. I recommend that you use the settings that you see here because they work. And I don't really want to go into a lot of detailed information in this video because this is basically a quick setup video. So you can follow along, use what I'm using here. And the other thing that you need to choose is your transmit power. Now, since analog APRS is an FM signal that's going out to a repeater or to an iGate, unless you're really close to one of those systems, I recommend that you use a high to make sure you're going to hit the repeater. Now, if you are able to hit the repeater with a lower power, of course you should use that lower power. Okay, and that basically sets up the analog APRS so that it's ready to go once we turn it on. I'm going to show you a little later in the video how you turn that on. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to switch over to the digital side just briefly because we're at this screen and we might as well set it. So the digital APRS in the radio, it will send an APRS signal to a talk group that you choose right in this block here, and it will be sent at a private call as a private call, which is what SMS text is about. And my delay time, my standard delay time here is 200 milliseconds. That works very well. So you would enter for your country or your location the Brandmeister talk group that is set up to accept APRS packets. And like I say, in this case in the US, it's 310.999. Now, this section here is what's called your report channels. There's eight selections that you can do. You can see that I have two selected that are specific channels, and then the balance I've left as current channel. So there's a couple different ways that you can set up how the APRS works. You can send on a specific channel that you tune your radio to, or you could use current channel and the radio will transmit APRS on the channel that you're on currently, providing that channel has been set up to send APRS data. We're going to get to that in a little while. But what happens is the radio will use either the selected channels information or the current channels information to send packets, meaning that on a current channel, it would send the time slot and the color code that is on that channel. You can actually choose the time slot if you'd like, slot one or slot two, but typically if you use channel slot, then you're going to get whatever matches the channel that you're on or the channel that you've specified. And we're going to look at both of those further. So why would I want a specific channel? Well, I like to be able to send basically on channels that I know. And I set a 3100 through my Zoom spot for, I think, digital. And then I think I use analog on the Pennsylvania talk group to send. And that, I could be wrong. We're going to take a closer look at that when we look at these channels. Now, to go a little bit further on current channel, what this means is every channel that you select in your radio has the ability to send APRS through current channel, but that channel must have the settings set. So remember that we're going to use current channel in report channel 3. So, and the 3100 would be 1, the 3142 would be 2. So that's basically setting up the actual report channels for DMR APRS in the APRS screen. Now we're going to actually shut this down and I'm going to go to these channels, okay? So, drop down, I was in my Zoom board. I have mine set up to where my channels are segregated based on the repeater or based on the hotspot that I'm using. So let's look at the Zoom 3100 channel. Okay, so this channel would normally be set up for whatever repeater or a hotspot. In my case, it's Simplex. And then all your contact information for sending this channel is normal. All of this is normal all the way down through the scan list. Now, this small section right here is what controls whether analog or digital or none will be sent. So in the 3100 Zoom channel, which is digital report channel 1 in the APRS, DMR APRS settings, that would basically correlate. Now, in this case, because I'm sending analog, I don't need to use any of that digital report channel because the analog signal goes out as an FM analog. Now, so the report type, you can choose analog or you can choose digital. So let's look at digital. If I choose digital, now the report channel is turned on. So I know that Zoom 3100 was my number one report channel. So if I'm sending digital, this channel in the report channel box of APRS settings has to be the same as what you choose here in the channel selection. So what you've done here is you've said, I want digital DMR APRS, and I'm using channel 1, which matches 3100, and here is the PTT mode. It's off. So in that particular case, it's going to automatically send the DMR APRS settings. But choosing here, you could choose this to be on, okay? And basically, it just allows you to send APRS data with a PTT or turn it on with a PTT. So basically going to go back now and I'm going to reset this channel to analog and I'm going to choose the PTT mode to send the data out at the end of the transmission. You can choose at the start of the transmission or the end of the transmission or off. If you choose off when you PTT, you won't send any APRS. Again, I choose end of transmission. So for this particular specific channel, ZUM 3100, it's going to use all the settings, color code, frequencies of that particular repeater or hotspot, and it's going to be sending the analog signal of APRS out on the specified FM analog channel in the APRS setup screen. Now, the one thing I will point out to you is there is a small box down here called SMS confirmation. This should not be checked. In the way Anytone and also many of the other radios apply the SMS data, this can cause confusion when you're sending SMS. So in this case, we want to make sure that we do not check SMS confirmation. We want to leave that unchecked. And that basically is an analog channel with a little bit of digital mixed in. So we're going to go now, we're going to be okay. So this is the channel that I chose to be the digital channel. So you'll see it's the channel is ZUM 3142. That was the report channel in number two, report channel number two. So you see this is saying four, that would be incorrect. So while we're in here, we have digital turned on, okay? We're going to choose the PTT mode to be on, okay? And then this report channel has to match the specific report channel that's in the APRS setup screen. So I'm going to change this to the correctly be two. Now this channel is now set up. When you turn your radio on this channel, it's going to start sending digital APRS. Okay, so let's go back and review here what settings I have up here. Okay, again, ZUM 3100, not used in the digital mode because I set it up for analog. I could set it up for digital, and in that case, I would select report channel number one in the channel information. Now, we went over ZUM 3142, and that was set up for digital. We selected report channel two. The radio will now use all the information, signal-wise, frequency, color code, slot of the ZUM 3142 channel. So let's talk a little bit more about what current channel can do for you. Well, basically at this point, the radio sending DMR APRS only will use the settings from the current channel the radio is on. Okay, now why is that important? Well, if we go back and select another channel here, let's say TAC 310, okay, on my ZUM board, I have nothing turned on here, okay? But if I wanted to send digital APRS, I would select digital. I like the PTT mode to be on. The report channel, this has to match a digital channel, report channel setting in the APRS setup screen that is current channel, because we don't have a specific channel in that report section, report channel section. So this would have to be between 3 and 8 the way I have it set up right now. Now, what that means is when you select 3 here, get out of here, that is saying that when you're on, when your radio is physically tuned to TAC 310 on my ZUM board, it's going to use APRS report channel 3, which says current channel. So it's going to use all the information from this channel here for slot, for color code, and for frequency. Now, if you choose to use current channel and you want to always be able to send APRS, you could set every channel in your radio to turn on digital and have report channel 3. And that's how current channel, it would mean whatever current channel you're on, as long as it's set up correctly in the channel information here for APRS, will send APRS out using the current channel settings. So in that particular case, this will allow you to override the limitation of having only 8 digital channels assigned. So once you're in current channel, As long as you turn that, put whatever channel you want to send on to the settings of APRS turning on, and you have to select the report channel that says current channel, then you'd be able on every channel of your radio send out APRS data. So that will eliminate the 8-channel requirement. However, if you have a channel that you turn your radio on that is not set up to send APRS, obviously you won't get anything sent. So that kind of covers what I wanted to today. I hopefully there if there's any questions, I'm usually around on the Facebook pages. You could feel free to find me on Facebook, Dwayne N6DMR, and Dwayne Reese, REESE. My first name's Duane, and you can feel free to give me a private message, and I'd be glad to help you given the time. Okay, so thanks a lot. I appreciate it. That pretty much is it for this video, and I thank everyone for your positive comments if you make them, and I will listen to any critiques, of course. So thanks again. Take care.